Hello everyone, this is my latest rainbow portrait about a fluffy dog named Mojo. I made this piece for a returning commissioner, and somehow the first few minutes are gone. I couldn't find it, but I hope this will still be an interesting video for you. This is the first time that I paint a dog with such a curly fur, so I thought it would be nice to experiment with it. Usually I don't really draw the individual hairs, but in this case I really wanted to represent them. Rainbow portraits usually start with a basic sun yellow color. It is the best if you use the brightest color first. I paint the eyes, and I use purple, the complementary color, for outlining them. I already have a color palette that I like to use, bright and vivid, but if the customer asks for something special, I try to make it so. These portraits can be really relaxing when you know what colors and shades you use, but you really need to try them out first if they are working together or not. So before you start the actual process, you need to brainstorm and study the color theory. On this piece, as I mentioned earlier, I experimented, so my process is a bit different. Now, I recolor the hair strings so they can pop out and you can feel the dimension when I finish the piece. When I'm working on a commission, I always check in the reference photo I got, so I can see the shadows, the lights, and I will use a darker color on a place where the shadows were, and I use a brightest, where it was the lightest. After that, I started to paint within with a paler shade of the chosen color of the individual hair string. Mojo originally a white pup, so I didn't want him to become spotted because of the different shades. The highlights are pale yellow. Since yellow is the brightest color on the color wheel, it always stands out from the others. Oh, and the spots and the circles are made with a custom brush. I draw them the same time as the base color and try to get the most interesting composition. I outline the nose with the same shade of purple as the eyes, and paint in with a brighter shade. I usually not recommend to use Titan White to highlight things, but since it's more abstract than a realistic piece, it's fine. It gives a more cartoonish feel to it. You could see on the video that there were some spots and freckles that I left out. It's because I work on a laptop, and it seems that it couldn't handle the OBS perfectly, and it lagged for me. So after the recording, I went back and repainted those areas. It took me about 7 hours to finish. I hope you enjoyed my painting process. If you have any questions, please do ask, and I will try to answer as best as I can. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.